football is back on FS1, and they arrived early for week zero in Maverick Stadium in Logan, Utah. The defending Mountain West champions are back in action as Utah State hosts UConn on a beautiful day in the northeast part of Utah. Alex Faust, Petros Papadakis here with you. We'll hear from Dean Blandino as well. It's a new era for UConn as Jim Mora takes over for the Huskies. His first game as head coach in stores, but he takes on a really difficult program in Utah State, the defending Mountain West champions, led by Logan Bonner, one of nine super seniors on the roster, returning for a fifth year of eligibility, his 26th consecutive start leading this explosive offense.
Coming in from the south, from Arkansas State with Coach Anderson to take the West by storm, caught everybody off guard in the conference last year, getting the ball out, very competitive, very passionate, nifty with his legs, and he led one of the great seasons in Utah State history, looking to do even better in 2022. Can't wait to see this kid take some snaps.
They're going to need a big-time defensive turnaround at UConn, and this might be the guy to lead it for them, Jackson Mitchell, the top returning tackler for the Huskies.
Coach Mora's name synonymous with defense. He's coached a lot of great linebackers over the years. Sam Mills, a Hall of Famer, comes to mind. He loves this kid, Jackson Mitchell, who's been a mainstay at UConn, productive tackling, run defense, great instincts. He's going to have his work cut out for him against an explosive offense today in Logan.
Utah State coming off a historic 2021 season, 11 wins for the Aggies, a bowl victory, a conference championship, and they are looking for more in 2022. We kick things off in Logan next. ...87-degree day in Logan, Utah. It's warm down to the field, heat radiating off the field, though we've heard it's a little bit cooler than the season opener last year for UConn when they were at Fresno State, and it was in the 90s. Blake Anderson leading things for Utah State. What a job he's done. This program was in tatters at the end of the 2020 season. What a resurrection from one win to 11 over the course of one season. Jim Mora, first time as a head coach in 5 years after six seasons at UCLA. One of the great student atmospheres in college football. They turn out not just for football, but basketball, everything at this university. The students are into it. Utah State will get the ball first. UConn won the toss. They deferred to the second half.
Don't look now, Alex, but we are in the golden age of Utah State football. And it's been a few different coaches, a few different styles, but Blake Anderson and what they've brought to the table starting last year has been a shock and a lot of fun to watch.
Despite winning the conference, despite returning their quarterback and a whole slew of players on defense, they are missing some key receivers from last year. We'll talk about that as we go along. Devin Tompkins, Brandon Bowling, 3,300 plus yards between them. No longer with the Aggies. And they were picked to finish third this season in their division. A little bit of disrespect perhaps for the defending champions of the Mountain West Conference. Noe Rulis, the sophomore from West Hartford, Connecticut, will kick things off momentarily for UConn. And we are underway. Terrell Vaughn will let it bounce out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. And Logan Bonner jogs out onto the field. The super senior transferred in from Arkansas State when Blake Anderson took over the job here. And Bonner has been fantastic. And he's had a lot of pretty good receivers to work with.
And it's the offense. They have a very fast attacking style offense. The defense is the same way. They complement each other pretty well, and he's the guy with the confidence and the swagger to get it done consistently week in and week out. He showed that last season.
Calvin Tyler Jr. lines up next to him in the backfield, the Oregon State transfer. And Bonner rolling to his right on the first play from scrimmage, connects with Brian Cobbs at about the 33-yard line, tackled by Ian Swenson.
We talked about filling in some of those gaps last year with the receivers that left. Brian Cobbs, a transfer from Maryland, one of those guys, productive already.
Gain of nine, second down and one. They'll hand it off to Tyler. And Tyler will move the sticks. Malik Dixon on the stop. as we give you the lineups here. First with Utah State. Four starters return on their offensive line, one of the most experienced O-lines in the nation, a combined 95 games of experience for Utah State. But again, the question is at receiver as Tyler gets another carry here and will get a couple of yards on first down.
Playing with a lot of pace, and that's what you expect from Utah State with the altitude. They can really take advantage of it, and Calvin Tyler, they say, in a lot better shape this year than last.
Led Utah State with 884 yards on the ground last year. We'll play action here. Bonner will take off and scamper across the 40-yard line. Brandon Boyer Randall, the transfer from Texas Tech, on the stop, and it's third down.
Good job by Randall kind of breaking down and making that tackle. Bonner pretty nifty with his feet. You saw him looking downfield. He came off about two receivers and then took off for three.
Third and long here for the Aggies. They were 44% on third down last year. Second best of the conference. Top 21 in the nation. Bonner across the middle and dropped. And that was nearly reeled in by Kyle Van Leeuwen. Chris Sheeran in coverage for UConn. The Aggies will punt.
They had the look they wanted. They brought the back out on a swing route to kind of spread things, and was a clear throwing lane for Van Leeuwen to catch that ball. A wide receiver should be able to catch that right above his head. Good job by UConn forcing the punt against a great offense.
Steven Kotzenle returns as the punter for Utah State. And he boots this one away. Back to receive is Keelan Marion, and it will take a UConn bounce and roll all the way to the 21-yard line. So the net on the punt, not that great. All things considered, just 37 yards. And the UConn offense will take the field here. Taquan Roberson is out there with the offense. Question mark of who would start a quarterback, but all signs just watching the reps and hearing from those at UConn's practice is that Roberson stood out during the offseason and into training camp.
Their best option, the most ready to handle this offense. They say he's a real study rat in Coach Charlton's office. We'll see if it pays dividends here in a hostile environment.
Roberson, the Penn State transfer. From the 21-yard line, a handoff on first down. There goes Nathan Carter, top returning rusher for UConn. And a great start for the Huskies.
A very nice patient mesh there. And Roberson does a good job of staring down that end. Byron Vaughn's giving it the last second. And Carter knows what to do with it, getting upfield.
Give him 13 yards and a first down right off the hop for UConn. They went into Clemson last year and had a 99-yard kickoff return for a touchdown. So don't be surprised if they can rattle off some explosive plays. And there goes Carter again. Carter finally hauled down inside the Utah State 15. Hunter Reynolds brought him down. But here come the Huskies early in this game.
The sophomore out of Rochester, look at this turn he makes on the cutback right there. Sees it beautifully and then keeps it skinny to get away from the linebackers in pursuit. That's A.J. Vongpachon, and he just shows his speed. A huge start running the ball for UConn. A stop against an explosive offense and rolling on the ground to start this one off in Logan.
13 and then 52 on the ground for Carter. And they're set up with a first down of the Utah State 14. Roberson takes the snap, hands it off to Brian Bruton. He was the guy who had that 99-yard kickoff return against Clemson last year. And he'll burrow his way forward for a yard. Second down.
We'll see how deep they go at the tailback position. They obviously want to run the ball. They've shown that early. There's Coach Charlton calling the plays. Bruton's the second string guy, it looks like. And Nathan Carter is going to be the male carrier, but needs a little bit of a break after that long run. I would too.
Nick Charlton is 33 years of age, the offensive coordinator for UConn, coming over from the University of Maine out of the Colonial. This will be thrown away by Roberson. Aaron Turner, the intended target, and it's third down.
I like the decision by Roberson. He's shown a lot of patience to start this game, especially going over to his right. First with the mesh on the first play of the game for the 13-yard gain. That time, not trying to force anything, throwing it away, knowing that you already have a good drive going.
First pass attempt for the Huskies. But it is third and 12. Two back set with Carter and Bruton for UConn. A swing here to Carter. And Carter has a block. Gets down to the 5-yard line. He is shy of the line to gain. A.J. Carter for UConn, for Utah State, no relation, made the stop.
Well, they are really using these backs, and this is a free release, and it's a screen, a flare screen. And
they're going to go for it here. Roberson pushing the pile. I think he has it. He does.
Yeah, he got it. They went right under center and gave Utah State a little bit of a taste of their own medicine with some pace after the nice screen with Sen leading through. Roberson handling his business on fourth and short, and now Coach Morris' team with a great opportunity to score a touchdown.
Here's where things will get a little tricky for UConn. They had only 12 touchdowns on 28 red zone trips last year. Well, this has been a phenomenal opening drive. It's Carter again, and he pinballs his way to the 2.
And this is a team in UConn. We talked to Coach Mora, desperate to win. A real chip on their shoulder, and we can go through it throughout the afternoon, but it's been hard times in stores in recent years. And Coach Mora is a passionate guy, a nuts and bolts football guy, and they look inspired to start this one out, Alex.
Robert Burns lining up as a blocking fullback here. They're going to hand it off to it, appears. Stop made just shy of the goal line.
It looked like he had the push and the leg drive to get in, but they're going fast. You see Charlton calling play.
They want to go now. Roberson gets a push. Does he have it? Touchdown. A flag comes in. The initial signal was for touchdown, but let's see the call here.
I think they got the defense coming on and off with the substitution there, Alex. So this is probably a declinable penalty.
Offside, number 3, defense. That penalty is declined. Touchdown.
What a start. A UConn team that had just one win all of last season. They have come into Logan and scored a punch in the mouth early in this game.
They kick the ball away. They defend. They get a punt, and they march down the field with just some short passes from Roberson, some good runs, good decision-making, especially the throwaway we saw closer to the goal line, and it translates into 6 points, maybe 7, for the Huskies. What a start to the Jim Mora era.
Tremendous start. 79-yard drive, 69 came on the ground. And it is 7-0 to the Huskies on the road in an intimidating environment, but they have silenced the crowd in Logan. Nathan Carter leading the way for UConn, and they're up 7-0. Who saw this coming?
Not me.
UConn came in roughly a 26-point underdog. It actually caught the attention of head coach Jim Mora during the week. He wasn't asked about it. Unprompted, he brought it up. And, you know, I don't think he's walked into many games in his career where his team has been that much of an underdog.
Well, he's got a lot to prove to himself. This team's got a lot to prove to each other. And he loves it at UConn, he says. He likes the vibe. He likes having an impact on the young people. And they've had an impact early in this game. There's no doubt about that.
Reset the ball here.
Where's Lucy?
We're only in week 0, Petros. Jordan Wilmore back to receive this kickoff. Well, now if you're Utah State, I don't know if you poke the bear or the Aggie in this case, how angry they will get and what they will do in response.
Well, they're not a lot of a respond to the opponent type of style with Utah State. They're more of a we do what we do, we're going to get out there and attack you. And offensively, they just couldn't get the motorcycle started.
Be another touchback to start.
But they'll keep coming, Alex. Bonner will keep coming throughout the game. They will take their shots, and they will not go quietly or be run over. And don't forget about the altitude. It is a huge factor playing in Logan for this team and for the team from UConn. It could get rough.
This is also not necessarily new territory. They trailed at the half in 8 of their 14 games, as you saw there. The first quarter, they would fall behind quite regularly. We were joking with Blake Anderson, their coach. It made him fun to watch. Certainly not from his standpoint, fun to coach. So on first down, there's Calvin Tyler Jr. to rip off a nice run to begin the drive. Durante Jones with a stop after a 13-yard pickup and a first down.
Tyler Jr.'s got great acceleration, and you saw some of it there, just really quick into the second level.
And the Aggies working quickly, as they are wont to do. Tyler bounces off his lineman and takes off past midfield into UConn territory. Wrestled down just before the 40-yard line by Caleb Anthony. A 22-yard run for Tyler. And the Aggies' run game is in gear.
The reason he's their number one guy is just that. He can stop his feet and then get started right away in a hurry and eat up a lot of yards. See if he can get 3 in a row. This is where the altitude and the conditioning really hurt Calvin Tyler Jr. last year.
Spotted the ball at the 40-yard line. Tyler again. That's about 2 or 3 here. Well, they feel here, much as, you know, any team that plays at altitude, the later you get in a game, the more of an advantage it will be. Their conditioning, they practice hard, they practice fast.
Yeah, it's a big part of their style. They use the place, their location, as an advantage. They run a great deal in practice. They have an attacking style. They sprint to the line of scrimmage. Very often they sprint from the sideline. It's just Coach Anderson's style.
Tyler checks out. Pailate Makakona, the senior, checks in. They'll throw it. And right along the near sideline, Brian Cobbs reels it in. That'll move the sticks.
Second target for Cobbs, second catch. They're still trying to find that production. Who's going to step up at wide receiver in lieu of Tompkins, who was so special last year?
9-yard gain at the 29-yard line. Here is Makakona. Picks up a couple on first down. Ball came out late. UConn says they have it. Well, coming away with the ball is Jackson Mitchell. What's the call here?
That ball,
the ruling is fumble
out.
Recovered
ruling
by UConn.
It was a fumble recovered by the defense.
Wow.
First down, Connecticut. Timeout.
And another plot twist early. A turnover from the Aggies.
In a primetime showdown, Penn State faces Purdue.
Are you kidding me?
He's going down.
Coverage begins Thursday night at 7 Eastern on Fox.
Advin, a solid drive for Utah State, gets ripped away literally by Jackson Mitchell.
We told you he was a playmaker. Look at Jackson Mitchell beat the block, come back, get the hands on the ball from Makakona, and then have the strength, which is incredible, to pull it away and keep possession to make it a turnover. What a play by the special linebacker for the Huskies.
So UConn back to work, up 7-0 on the road in Logan. This is, we're not going to sugarcoat it. This is a stunning start, not just for the visiting team, but for the home team as well.
Well, you would expect Utah State's offense to be a little more crisp to start this game. There's no doubt about it. And maybe you would expect a little bit more of a deer in the headlights feel from a UConn team with half a new roster and a brand new head coach, but it has not played out that way so far. Still early.
Yeah. UConn didn't even play a season in 2020. Didn't do a spring season, didn't do anything. They sat the year out, had to rebuild the program. Roberson's going to keep this. And he'll try to shake a tackle that comes about 3 yards shy here.
It looks like he got a little shaken up.
To Roberson at the end of the play. That's not good.
Yeah, he ducked his head and... Was that Michael Onyewu?
Yeah.
That he was one-on-one with, and he takes the physical brunt of this collision here. He tries to make a move, and Onyewu did a good job just getting right to his legs and getting him down.
He's holding his right knee after the play.
Yeah, it looks like he landed awkwardly the second time. His foot kind of hit the ground. They do have two other quarterbacks that we should probably see today in some form, one or the other. Cale Millen from Washington, of the great Millen family, and then Zion Turner, one of the biggest recruits in UConn history. And it looks like it's going to be him, Alex.
So he's the youngest of the four quarterbacks on their roster. True freshman, St. Thomas Aquinas High School in Florida. Prolific high school program. They like him. They feel he will be a starter at some point, but doubt that they considered using him in this capacity this early. We knew we were going to see him today. But early on, he's going to have to step in here off the bench, third down and three, after Roberson, the Penn State transfer, leaves with an injury. In the gun, Turner hands it off. And it'll be a first down for the Huskies. First time we see for UConn, Devontae Houston carrying the ball today.
Yeah, Houston on the end around with Valentin Sen leading through. He already had a great lead block on the first drive on a screen. And Jim Mora keeping the ball on the ground with his offense and Nick Charlton's play calling, but also exploiting the whole field side to side.
First down for the Huskies. And again, they'll go to the run game. This time it's Bruton. As UConn steadily approaching midfield here.
Well, you mentioned Bruton in the return game and that 99-yard return he had against Clemson last year. He's also from St. Thomas Aquinas, a Miami guy.
Mostly worked on kick return duty last year, Bruton. He had two kick returns for a touchdown. He's tied for second most in FBS. Two back set here with Bruton and Carter. And it's Carter. Beg your pardon, it is Bruton. Gets the call.
They bring Bruton across the formation here. Just a zone look with Carter kind of leading through, and he makes a brilliant cut underneath. And this UConn run game isn't going away.
That's a great tackle by A.J. Carter to stop what would have been a first down. They are inches away. They're going to mark it about a yard short. Third and one here.
This clock running, yeah. Short runs. This is what frustrates Logan Bonner standing on the sideline.
Carter again. Well, this UConn team that had an average possession time last year of 25 minutes and 49 seconds. Instead, they have control of the ball here.
And Jim Mora looks really comfortable playing in third and one. He brought in Robert Burns, the fullback, and led through. And right now, they are punching Utah State in the mouth at the line of scrimmage. Yeah.
So the prior play, they actually had given them a first down. So it was a first down play. That nets one, and now it's second and nine as they approach midfield. Turner drops back to pass, escapes the pressure, throws near side, picked off. Hunter Reynolds gets the takeaway. Flag on the play.
Obviously an ill-advised throw from the freshman.
See Ephraim Bonda, the defensive coordinator for Utah State, in your picture. And again, a team that trailed after the first quarter in more than half their games last year. But might this be the first turning point?
There are two fouls on the play. Holding, number 71 offense. That penalty is declined. After the interception, personal foul. Blindside block, number 17 of the return team. That's a 15-yard penalty from the spot of the foul. First down, Utah State.
That's a second-generation player, Luke Marion, but it is a turnover by UConn. They might have corrected the number on the penalty, but we'll sort that out when we come back. First mistake from the Huskies today, and it's the freshman quarterback, Zion Turner.
What's the trick?
Here's what happened with the pick on the freshman, Zion Turner, Alex. Hunter Reynolds, right there in the middle of the screen, number 27, right above the referee, is going to read the eyes of Turner, and you see him drifting with him, and he absolutely knows where that ball is going. Turner had no idea. His very first pass ever in college football, picked off by the graduate transfer from Michigan.
Three seasons at Michigan for Reynolds. And a big play early here. UConn only led by two possessions in two games last season. An opportunity to go up by two possessions, but the turnover gives Utah State the ball back here. After all the penalty yardage, they are back in their own territory. And a throw to the near side is caught by Brian Cobbs. Cobbs tackled just shy of midfield, but there is a flag back by the line of scrimmage.
Looked like a free play for Bonner, and he knew it.
Number 96, defense. The penalty is declined. The result of a play is a first down.
Brian Cobbs, Maryland transfer, fifth-year senior.
So far, he's been the target, right?
Yeah. Four seasons in College Park. He's a pretty good receiver for them, used sparingly. 15-yard pickup.
The previous play is under further review.
Well, as far as the offsides goes, it was Pokesi Vakauta that was caught in the neutral zone there after the clap from Bonner.
Looking at the catch here is what we understand.
Yeah, that heel came down. The white shoe and the white paint.
That's close.
Two pretty good shots of it. It looks like that heel came down out of bounds. What a nice shot we have there.
Good on the replay booth, Mark Madsen.
So instead of the first down, it's likely that the Aggies will take the penalty.
Yep. 4:39 to go. What a series of major swings in this game. Obviously, UConn with a 79-yard drive to begin. Forced fumble on Utah State's second drive. Then Roberson gets injured, leading to the turnover by the freshman. Utah State looking for their first points of the season. Here's another look.
Cobbs kind of gets that leg out, that left leg sort of splits his legs to avoid the tackle from Anthony. And it looks like that's what made it what looks to be an incompletion.
So would have been a second and seven, or the play was a second and seven. It would be a 16-yard catch if this is ruled a catch. And is there anything definitive here that you see?
I mean, it looks like his heel is out of bounds. It really does. And you look at a couple of the other shots, and it's even more kind of definitive.
All right, Dean Blandino's back with us. Hi, Dean. Good to have you with us once again. What are you thinking here? What do you see?
Hey, guys. Well, let's hear from Derek Anderson first, and then we'll talk about it.
After review, the receiver's foot was out of bounds prior to catching the pass. It's an incomplete pass. However, we will enforce the offside penalty on number 96. It will be second down at the 35-yard line.
Yeah, so Petros was all over it. That left foot, you talk about a toe heel. If it's a normal step, the entire foot has to be in bounds, and it looked like the left heel touched out of bounds, and that's why they reversed it to incomplete. And that's a big moment for the referee. Whenever they can say however in the announcement, they love that.
Makes them sound smart.
Exactly. Thank you, Dean.
It was Dalmont Gordine that was the culprit.
After all that, it's a second and two after they enforced the offside penalty. And the ball at the Utah State 35. Bonner hands it off. And Tyler is unable to escape. He's frustrated. Jackson Mitchell again coming up with a big play, and it sets up third down.
He is a sure tackler and long out there on the edge.
Quickly, they're back to work. Tyler bounces off a man, but can't get to the next level. Mitchell is there again. Ian Swenson there as well. And Jackson Mitchell, who finished 12th in all of FBS football in total tackles last season, has been an impact player for UConn once again.
He came from the other side. It was Boyer Randall with the initial hit that slowed the play down, but really nice pursuit from Coach Mora, and he loves it.
And after the turnover, what a stand by this UConn defense that was the eighth worst in all of FBS football by total points allowed last year, and among the worst in total yardage allowed last year, over 450 per game allowed. They're standing firm early in this game. Fair catch signaled by Keelan Marion. And it will roll to the 21-yard line where the Aggies down it. And the Huskies will go back to work, leading 7-0. All right, tonight, it's Baseball Night in America on Fox. Ronald Acuna Jr. leads the Braves into a huge showdown against Paul Goldschmidt of the Cardinals. Giants take on Carlos Correa and the Twins. 6:30 Eastern is when coverage begins. Check your local listings for the games in your area. Wild card races have been fascinating to watch. The Braves have been on fire for the last month, it feels like. They're chasing down the Mets in the NL East. Well, for UConn, they are back to work, up 7-0 on the road. And here's Nathan Carter. Will he be caught? He's still on his feet, past midfield, into Utah State territory, and another chunk play for Nathan Carter, finally pushed out by Kaleo Neves after a huge gain.
Where is the Aggies' defense? Look at that hole, a beautiful lead block there. And he is out in the open, breaks the tackle of Gervin Hall easily. And Carter is ripping off big runs in the first half here.
44 yards for Carter. He had a run of 52 to begin the game. Meanwhile, this is Cale Millen, and he'll get a first down. We thought we might see him for precisely that reason. They love his legs. Transferred in from FCS Northern Arizona, and his first touch of the ball game.
These guys are blocking for each other. Look at Bruton leading through with the big block that sprung Millen to get to the edge. A great block by Jacob Flynn on the previous play. UConn is getting after it with a lot of aggression in a very hostile play.
22 yards, Huskies in the red zone. It's a first down, and Millen stays in at quarterback. Juggled the snap, trying to surge forward, and he can't get away. Sini Tuiaki, redshirt freshman from Salt Lake City, got a hand in there on the tackle.
Getting a lot of push with this UConn offensive line. Let's see what happened with Millen here. That looks like a designed quarterback run, kind of like a power, but with the bobbled snap, as you mentioned, Alex, the timing of the play was screwed up and he couldn't get behind his lead block.
Utah State averaged 161 rush yards against last year. UConn's already up to 150 today. Here comes Zion Turner back into the game. And again, Taquan Roberson, if you're just joining us, injured for UConn. He'll throw to the end zone. It is caught! Keelan Marion! But they're going to wave it off. Marion had it initially. It popped out of his hands as he hit the ground. Andre Grayson was there for Utah State.
Strong hands contest, Alex, between Marion and Grayson.
The ruling on the field is the receiver possessed the ball in the end zone prior to it being stripped out. Touchdown.
Now they signal touchdown.
So we have dueling signals, but it did look like he had it tucked and then it came over in his head. Keelan Marion does win the strong hands battle.
And he's shaking up.
One throw for a pick, another one for a touchdown. Welcome to college football, Zion Turner.
Yeah. This is stunning stuff.
Letting the true freshman quarterback drop back and put it in the air and an accurate ball.
That's his second pass. Right? The first one was the interception.
Going on the field of a touchdown is under further review.
I figured it would be. Just to put into context here for UConn, their last road victory of any kind was 2019. Their last win was in a season opener was 2017.
Well, here's Marion. You see him tuck it. He's got it, his elbows down. And Grayson kind of battles with the ball while he's on the ground and seemingly already had possession. Now remember, this happens a lot faster in real time. We're watching it in slower motion, and we'll talk to Dean about it, I'm sure, but that might be hard to overturn if the ruling on the field is touchdown.
All right, Dean, what do you think?
Yeah, to me, this is a touchdown. The receiver's going to the ground to make the catch. He maintains control. He rolls over. And that's that time element, the time to perform an act common to the game. And then it's the defender that pulls it out after that time element is met. So to me, this is a catch. Great job on the field getting together, discussing it. Obviously, replay's going to take a second look. But the ruling on the field, to me, should stand.
Is there a difference, Dean, or what is the difference between surviving the ground in the NFL versus college football, let's say?
Basically the same rule. It's still an element of time, and it doesn't matter if it's in the field of play or the end zone. If you're going to the ground to make the catch, you got to survive the ground or perform an act common to the game, like reach the ball out for the line to gain. Not the case here, but he does survive the ground and roll over.
After further review, the ruling on the field stands. Touchdown.
Keelan Marion is their go-to receiver. Little shaken up after that play, but good strong hands against Andre Grayson there.
UConn's largest run last season was 46 yards.
Yeah, this is a different football team. I think we're learning very quickly.
Carter already has a run of 44 and 52 today. And with a minute 38 to go in the first quarter, it is 14-0 for the Huskies. I mentioned it's a new era for UConn, and bringing in a coach with some name brand credibility. This is Jim Moore's fourth stop as a head coach. Went to the NFC Championship with the Atlanta Falcons. To the Seahawks after that, and then to UCLA, where he went to four bowl games. Made a mark at UCLA for sure.
Well, there's no doubt about it, and he energized that program when he came in. And you're seeing some of that here with UConn. They were immediately more physical. Guys understood their role. People were being very, very diligent at UCLA right when Mora took over. I remember that distinctly, and Brett Hundley had so much success at the quarterback position. This is a much bigger reclamation project for Coach Mora, and what they've done so far in this first quarter has been the stuff of legend in UConn, the Constitution State.
Oh, you want to get into Connecticut trivia. I can go toe-to-toe with you on that, my friend. Nathan Carter has 120 yards. The entire Utah State offense has 71.
Not what you'd expect.
Listen to that. I mean, it is stunned silence.
Yeah, they're stunned here in Logan. This is a great game day atmosphere at Maverick Stadium, Merlin Olsen Field. They expect to see a lot of fireworks. And Logan Bonner and his offense unable to really generate that. They've had some throws out to Cobbs. Tyler with a couple bursts here and there, but nothing sustained so far, which is not to say they can't get that engine going in a very quick way.
First three possessions for Utah State. Punt, fumble, punt. Bonner throws to the outside and has his man. It's the tight end, Josh Sturzer. And he'll get within a couple of yards of the sticks.
They don't use a lot of the tight ends in the throwing game. Sturzer with only four receptions last year. They get him going in the first quarter here.
Give him eight, second down and two. They'll work quickly. They'll keep it on the ground and they'll get the first down. Robert Briggs getting the carry there. Again, Utah State, they lost their two top receivers from last season. accounting for 3,300 yards and 31 touchdowns. Terrell Vaughn, his first catch of the game, and Vaughn spins away from an initial tackle, rumbles to near midfield. Price Yates finally brought him down, the redshirt freshman defensive end, as Vaughn picks up a nice gain in the first down.
Now this is the type of thing that Utah State can do. They move around a little bit in the middle of the field, and now they're playing very fast.
11 yards as Robert Briggs again gets the call, and he's into UConn territory. Clock inside of a minute to go, first quarter.
Briggs is the third straight back. We've seen Makakona fumble, product out of Texas.
And off again, there goes Briggs. And he's stood up by Chris Schoen in the secondary for UConn. A 15-yard gain, another first down for Utah State.
Dangerous tackle there by Schoen, not wrapping up. I thought Briggs was going to bounce off and keep going.
Bonner, play action, throws over top of the intended target, Vaughn, former junior college All-American.
They're starting to get some of their pace back, some of their edge back, but they just haven't been able to consistently move this offense, and you'd have to say a big part of it is Coach Mora's defense.
21 seconds left in the quarter. Play clock inside of 7 here. Bonner sets up with Briggs to his right. And off to Briggs, looking for the edge. Briggs spins away from a tackle and is knocked down at the 30-yard line on a gain of 5. And that should take us to the end of the quarter. See if they work quickly here and get another play before the quarter ends. They will not. But what a quarter it was.
Wow.
For the visiting UConn Huskies, they have not led by more than 10 points at the end of the first quarter in any game since 2015. They are off to a 14-0 start in the altitude in Logan, Utah. Metros, you ready?
I am.
Biggest sporting event on the planet returns to Fox Sports. Christian Pulisic in the U.S., Lionel Messi, Argentina, Cristiano Ronaldo in your picture.
My Greek's got a team this year.
I don't know, but it's the World Cup, and it's taking place in the holidays this year. The FIFA World Cup live from Qatar starting November 20th on Fox and FS1. And no, they will not be playing in the snow. It's still hot at time of year in Doha. New quarterback for Utah State is Levi Williams, the transfer from Wyoming. He surges ahead here, and it's going to be a fourth down set up, fourth and inches for Utah State. We figured we would see him as well in this game. But Utah State just looking for something here as we begin the second quarter. The Aggies, reigning champions of the Mountain West Conference, trailing by 14 to the UConn Huskies, who had just one victory all of last season. Independent team in FBS football. Fourth and inches, play action, and a throw gets away from Williams. He would have had the first down. Parker Buchanan, the backup tight end, had daylight.
This is part of the perils of bringing in a different quarterback package, the old belldozer. Levi Williams is an accurate thrower. We've seen him play very good quarterback at Wyoming. They have him in to run the ball. They tried to catch him off guard, and just a little too much juice for Levi to start this game. Would love to have that one back.
He was a really good quarterback, too, at Wyoming. Passed for over 2,000 yards. And that huge win over Kent State last year, bowl game.
He beat Utah State last year as the quarterback of Wyoming. And you look at what's going on the UConn side and what they've pulled off. And the game so far that their offensive coordinator, young guy, former head coach of Maine, Nick Charlton, has put together, been really impressive. Let's see what he does here.
Now Huskies take over on downs. Two touchdowns, their first three possessions. And why not go back to Nathan Carter? They can't stop him, but they do strip the ball. And Utah State will have it back. That is a huge break because Carter would have been into the clear again. Daniel Greshick, the transfer from Nevada. And Carter with a huge mistake. The Huskies cough it up. And their second turnover of the afternoon.
They're trying to keep him motivated and not getting down on the sideline, because they're going to need Nathan Carter if they're going to compete throughout this game. A great strip there. And Greshick does a good job of tracking down that ball and diving on it.
Well, the UConn defense held after their first turnover, the interception thrown by the freshman Zion Turner. Logan Bonner back into the game for Utah State. And he has Tyler in his hip pocket. He'll give it to Tyler. And Tyler bounces off a tackle. Dalmont Gordine with the stop. Well, you might expect a sloppy game in a lot of respects. The first game of the season, week zero. But, boy, what a missed opportunity for UConn.
They've had a couple. They've made some mistakes. A true freshman with the pick.
Might be a double pass here. And it's incomplete. Brian Cobbs launching downfield for Josh Sturzer.
The one thing that's really jumping out to me, Alex, is you see Utah State trying to do some things to get their offense going, bringing in Levi Williams, throwing a double pass. Every time a UConn player almost makes a tackle or has a tackle broken, there's three other guys flying to the ball. They're really pursuing and playing with a lot of aggression, and it's all led by that guy, Jackson Mitchell, who's made some great plays.
Preseason watch list for the Butkus Award. Mitchell, junior from Ridgefield, Connecticut. Physical player, out there a ton. Doesn't seem to tire very easily. Bonner on third down, slings it to the sideline, and the catch is made. It'll be a first down for Utah State as Brian Cobbs hauls it in.
Well, at the last second, this became a different front, and Bonner noticed it right away. He did go out of bounds. One-on-one with Caleb Anthony there. I'm going to say he was pushed out, I guess.
We had time. I'd love to see another look at that.
Well, usually you can't just run down the white after somebody pushes you.
Right.
You didn't really have a great sense of urgency to get back in, but no flag, and the clock's running.
Ball is set. And now a whistle.
Timeout, Connecticut. It's their first of the half. TV timeout.
So we'll take it with them. Pay some bills. 14-0 UConn. Aggies drive. Well, it may not look like it today, but Utah State coming off a tremendous season last year. Beat Washington State, their first road win over a Power 5 team in 50 years. They won the Mountain West Championship over San Diego State. And then beat Oregon State for their first bowl win against a Power 5 program in program history. 11 wins last year that tied a program high. But they are in trouble early here. Second quarter, trailing 14-0. Calvin Tyler Jr. on first down gets the carry.
Boyer Randall right on top of him. Yeah, you know, Alex, it seems like every time Utah State has something going, somebody trips over their feet. You know, it just happened there with Calvin Tyler, but they score a touchdown here. There's going to be a lot of deep breaths taken, not just because of the altitude.
On second down, play action, a pass, caught for the touchdown, Kyle Van Leeuwen. And the Aggies are on the board.
Something to cheer about for the faithful. Good play fake, really sells it. Confident throw, just flips it over the middle for Van Leeuwen to go up and get.
So after a punt, a fumble, another punt, the Aggies with points off the UConn turnover. What would have been another big run for Nathan Carter But the ball stripped out of his hands. And the Aggies with their first score of the season.
Well, we've seen a lot of adversity for both teams so far, and we've seen how those teams have responded to adversity. That's what these coaches preach all camp, because the games never end up perfect. They never end up pretty. Something bad always happens. So you look at Utah State, you know, they've come out and they've been pushed around at the line of scrimmage by UConn throughout the whole beginning of this game, and they need to respond. And as far as UConn goes, they've hurt themselves with some turnovers, but they've responded to adversity. They lost their quarterback. Zion Turner comes in, throws a pick, then throws a touchdown. So it's been a really fun drama up and down, and we're only here at the lot of time to go in the second quarter.
I was going to say, a lot has happened in this game.
Look at that student section. They finally got something to do.
My goodness. They got here early, too, right when the gates opened, a gigantic crowd of them rushing to get the best seats in the house for this week zero matchup. A lot of teams in the Mountain West get that and play Hawaii. Get a waiver from the NCAA. It'll be a touchback. And we'll see if Nathan Carter can rip off another big run. He has a bunch of them already.
He's been deep into the secondary because of some very good push from his offensive line and some nifty cutting. He's also caught the ball well out of the backfield. Great eyes. You see him looking downfield. The ball security, though, you see that ball in one hand when the tacklers come up, and that's what ended up getting him with the fumble. See if UConn can overcome that turnover and touchdown, or if that got the Aggies the spark they needed to start their bonfire.
Carter has runs of 52, 44, and then 19 before the fumble. Already over 129 yards today. Approaching a career high. Yeah. Zion Turner back into the game, and it's an incomplete pass intended for Dejon Harrison, the Texas transfer.
I like the call from Nick Charlton, moving people around, making it a manageable throw for the young quarterback. Maybe threw it a little too hard, but either way, probably should have come up with it, was Harrison. There's the old Maine Black Bear.
Up in Orno. This will be a tackle for loss. Brian Bruton getting the call. And a loss of two after Kaleo Nevs, the junior from Provo, makes the stop.
Van Leeuwen with the touchdown catch, another Provo product. Nevs, a junior, disrupting that play early.
Now this is really the first time you've heard that boisterous Aggie student section all afternoon. Third and 12. Turner remains in the game for UConn. Drops back, feels the heat, gets rid of it, it's on the ground. An incomplete pass. Daniel Greshick brought the heat, and it'll be a three and out for the Huskies.
They call a screen play, something safe. Third and 12, not where UConn wants to be with the style of offense they've been running in this game. They try to run a little bit of a double screen, a good job by Turner just to eat the ball, throw it away, and punt it. But now you start to worry about the conditioning of the UConn D.
So Utah State with their first real defensive stand of the game, forcing a three and out. And George Karatan, the punter. This will take a UConn roll and gets muffed. Cooper Jones nearly coughed it up. Whoa. Utah State's defense finally coming up with the goods, trailing by seven. All right, Rob. Some people are picking Nebraska to compete in the Big Ten West this year. Like, for a division title.
Still early. It's week zero.
I get it, but
zero.
Even so.
Disappointing. Yikes. For Coach Frost.
Yeah. After he had his contract restructured and everything. Bonner throws and completes for the seventh time this afternoon. He's now 7 for 9. Justin McGriff catches it at the sticks.
And that's a guy they expect to pick up a lot of the slack in the wide receiver corps. 6'6" is McGriff, and that's how Bonner usually plays it. Ball's out right away. First down, momentum.
There's Tyler. We'll scamper ahead here. Give him 3 on the play.
The Utah State offense is a lot like their defense. They kind of stack successful plays. And when something happens like that, no gain, it slows down their momentum and allows the defense to get a little bit of their feet under them.
Tyler again. And he'll cross the 40-yard line. You know, their offensive coordinator, Anthony Tucker, had a little bit of time at UCF, 3 seasons there. And you could probably see a few hallmarks in their style, which was a carryover when Scott Frost was the coach at UCF.
It's a high-flying deal. I mean, this is an air raid offense. They get the ball out, they attack the defense, but they need to build momentum upon momentum. And UConn's done a great job of slowing momentum down. They're facing another 3rd and 4 after 2 pretty good stops.
Tyler gets nothing. Well, that was a 3rd down play. And it's 4th down approaching midfield. And Utah State's going to bring their punting unit on.
Jackson Mitchell has been a terror out there. He's in on every tackle. And Ian Swenson, number 6, the middle linebacker, has been cleaning up some of the missed tackles. These guys are really rallying to the football and
Aggies
after it.
Aggies are just 1 for 5 on 3rd down this afternoon. Line drive punt. That takes a Utah State hop out of bounds at the 10-yard line. And UConn's defense again holding tough. 14-7. It's been a minute or two since UConn last won a road game. 2019, fellow Independent,
wow.
UMass, and Amherst, Silent H, dominated. Kevin Mensah had 5 touchdowns. UConn scored 56 points.
It's been that guy and his linebacking core. Jackson Mitchell, Ian Swenson, Boyer Randall, Bembry, they've all made plays led by Jackson Mitchell and Jim Morris' defense.
Well, freshman Zion Turner completes over the middle. And again, UConn is having their way offensively. It's the tight end, Russell Dixon.
Move the quarterback, get him comfortable.
19 yards for Dixon. I mean, they're shredding this Utah State defense.
Charlton knows what his young quarterback is comfortable with, and he's finding it ever since that first turnover.
Yeah. Tried to cut back. Stood up behind the line. Able to surge ahead again.
Let's take a look at the freshman working. Little play fake to hold the linebackers. Tight end squirts out, makes a move. Ball security at the end. UConn came to play in the first half.
Over 200 yards of offense now. No gain on the play, 2nd down and 10. And it remains Zion Turner at quarterback. Play clock to 2. Here's the snap. Turner rolls left and throws it out of bounds.
Play by the quarterback. Some of these throwaways from Turner have been some of the best throws of the day for UConn. Just living to call another play and not make mistakes.
That's a nice recovery for the freshman on his first pass.
Sure was.
Threw an interception. 3rd and 10 for the 29. Quick throw. It's caught. Bruton. cuts it back and surges ahead after breaking the first tackle. A.J. Carter finally brought him down. It's a first down for the Huskies. A big third down conversion. They are now 3-for-6 on third down this afternoon.
What a violent run by Brian Bruton. They get in these third and long situations. They've been calling screens to keep Zion Turner comfortable. One of them blew up. That one was developed well. He got the ball to Bruton, but Bruton did it all himself, fighting for that first down. Inspiring.
I think your partner's even better. They're 3-for-5 on third down. Turner taking a shot, first time today, and overthrows his man. There's been a number change for UConn, so I don't have 86 down here, so this might be a player. Might be Dejon Harrison. We'll have to double check here.
To Johnny Carter.
All the way across the field, they try to get him on a opposite corner route, kind of, and no PI because I believe the ball was uncatchable.
Second down. Kevin Clercius was the intended target. Nathan Carter gets a yard here. But you got to like it taking a shot, though. You have an opportunity here, second quarter.
You have to give that quarterback the confidence, and you have to keep those safeties for Utah State honest because your run game has been very successful, and they're going to be creeping up. So very smart by Charlton to go deep just so they can look at it.
After a one-yard gain, it's third down and 9. And again, the Huskies 3-for-5 this afternoon.
Tough for the young quarterback, though, these third and long situations.
Turner feels pressure and throws it away. Got rid of it quickly. An incomplete pass, fourth down, and the Huskies will punt.
Well, you can see he's very eager to get rid of the ball on those third and longs. Nathan Carter with his back to him there in protection, and Turner just threw it at his back. Punting for UConn has not been the end of the world because their defense has played so well throughout this game, and they can flip the field here.
This is George Karatan, the Arkansas transfer. So this is a pretty good punt, too. Fielded at about the 11 by Cooper Jones. And he'll get a couple of yards on the return. 49-yard punt, 4-yard return. Can the Aggies make a pushback to tie this game? Second quarter. Well, Logan Bonner, solid so far, you'd have to say.
He hasn't taken over. And usually at this point, they've done more offensively. He's gotten the ball to Cobbs. He's still looking for those wide receivers, Kyle Van Leeuwen. Steps up with the touchdown catch. Finally getting to his big target out on the edge, McGriff. But look at what they've lost.
Yeah. A lot of production out the window for Utah State from last season.
Bowling was unbelievable in the conference championship game. And Tompkins was lights out all year.
That's had a heck of a kick return, saving Scarver. Bonner steps up. And Bonner, head first slide. Oh, awkward. Gain of about 2.
And he's a little shaken
up
there.
Yeah, he is.
He might have fallen on the ball, which knocks the wind out of you pretty good. Looks like he did.
Well, let's see if UConn's defense can again measure up. They flipped the field. They started on their own 10 last possession. 49-yard punt. Utah State beginning at their own 14. Robert Briggs in the backfield for the Aggies here. Second down and 8. Bonner gets rid of it quickly, and it skips off the hands of Kyle Van Leeuwen. Incomplete. Third down.
Jim Mora sent Jackson Mitchell flying into the backfield because he saw Bonner was a little shaken up there on first down, and I believe it affected the throw.
Jackson Mitchell was
relentless.
He's been a stud today for the Huskies.
And you see the pace just isn't there. The edge, the crispness is not there for the Aggies offense. And they're at home.
Bonner well protected and completes on a crossing pattern to get the first down. It's Cobbs to move the chains. 12 yards.
Nice recovery by Bonner there as we have an injured Husky. Is that Ian Swenson?
Ian Swenson, yeah.
This is just a one-on-one deal. Caleb Anthony has to go take care of the guy on the hitch, which brings Cobbs open. Well-designed play from the OC, Anthony Tucker.
Ian Swenson, veteran for this UConn team. He's stuck with this program through and through. Getting some medical attention here. He's played in nearly every UConn game since redshirting in 2017, staying with the program through that canceled season.
Absolutely, Alex, and we see him getting up under his own power there, looking at his left arm. He's shaking it around. But both of these teams have a lot of stories like that. UConn's situation was very much like Utah State's situation last year. New coach, whole bunch of new guys on the roster. There was some tumult and some bad feelings with the previous regime. And it's great to see the mix between the transfers and the guys that stuck it out, creating a new team. And that's a big part of modern college football now.
Yeah. Swenson with 7 tackles today. He exits. First down for the Aggies at their own 29. Bonner now 8 of 11, 100 yards. But Utah State crucially trailing by 7 in a game where they were heavily favored. Briggs surges ahead to pick up about 5. Give him 6 in the end.
Briggs, not a big guy. 5'6", 175, but he has been the most physical runner of the day thus far for Utah State.
Bryce Yates was in on the stop along with Brandon Boyer Randall. 2nd and 4.
Kalani.
Again, it's Briggs, but a flag comes in. What a physical tackle there by Durante Jones, the sophomore. We'll check the penalty marker here.
False start, number 78, offense. 5-yard penalty, 2nd down.
Utah State, not a heavily penalized team last year. About 55 yards a game. League and NCAA average, roughly.
That's on Jacob South. This is his 16th career start.
So it's 2nd and 9 now. A first down nearing midfield. Jackson Mitchell finally brought him down after a 17-yard gain.
Now what Blake Anderson's team has done is flip the field back to the 50-yard line. Utah State with a little bit of momentum.
Still not working as quickly as we thought that they would. Bonner to the near side. Connects with Van Leeuwen, who slips a couple of tackles inside the 30 and down to the UConn 23. Durante Jones with a tackle. There's a chunk play for the Aggies.
That relentless spread out attack, and you rely on missed tackles. There's 2 right there, and Van Leeuwen able to get a big chunk and a good threat for the Aggies going.
31 yards and a first down. Briggs untouched into the end zone. And Utah State an extra point away from tying this game.
Well, that's how fast it can happen. And just when we said they weren't playing fast and they weren't showing the pace, they start getting it fast. Pace right up the gut. Jacob South leading through. Briggs with a good physical run for a smaller guy took over that drive.
First career touchdown for the true freshman from Belleville, Texas, capping a 7-play, 86-yard drive. And in Utah State fashion, one that lasted less than 3 minutes. Tie game. Have the Aggies finally found their game offensively. From down 14-0. Brand new game. All right, 14-14. And Utah State rattling off 14 unanswered. 86-yard drive. A couple of big plays mixed in there, and we're all square.
Really contrasting styles here between Coach Mora talking to his OC there, Charlton, and Coach Anderson.
Who wants this ball? Off the kickoff. So for UConn, after Devontae Houston brings this out, let's see. You mentioned it. There have been so many big moments in this game already. They've faced adversity on multiple occasions. Well, now they've conceded 14 unanswered points on the road. What do they do?
They need to reestablish their run game. They need to run some clock. They cannot give the ball back to Bonner before the end of the half in a situation where they can score, and they can score from anywhere, because that defense is tired and they need to regroup. So right now, this UConn offense has to possess the ball. That's the most important part of this.
It's a throw off the hands of Robert Burns. Zion Turner remaining in, a quarterback, the true freshman from Florida. He had a couple of opportunities on the table to back up at larger programs, but decided to commit to UConn. Liked the school. Wanted to be part of a rebuilding effort, wanted playing time.
Generally regarded as the future of the program, and they're just trying to keep him calm and within the offense right now.
Turner hands it off, and it's Houston up to about the 28-yard line, a gain of four, and it's third down.
Still some really physical hitting going on around the line of scrimmage, and that was a good, strong run by Houston, setting up a more manageable third down for the young quarterback.
You want to recruit at the Division I program, you got to go to places like Roanoke, Alaska, to find guys for your program. Especially as an FBS independent, you got to find different ways to piece together a roster. Third down. Turner gets away from the pressure. Turner throws, and tiptoeing the sideline to make the catch is Russell Dixon, but it's an incompletion. They say he was out.
He was bobbling it as he went out of bounds. Otherwise, it would have been a catch, and a brilliant improvisation by Turner. There is a flag here and a hat off, which means somebody went out of bounds. Turner, a good job turning out of that, regaining his balance, turning his shoulders, finding a receiver on the edge.
Illegal touching, number 86 of the offense. That penalty is a loss of down at the previous spot. Fourth down.
So he went out of bounds already and then came back in.
They just had the number wrong, 85. Russell Dixon from Edmonton, Alberta, Canada.
Another independent recruit. Yeah,
exactly.
Huh?
Sun doesn't set till about 10:30 there at night in the summer. But the Huskies forced to punt here. And a fair catch is signaled at the 34-yard line. 2:41 to go in the first half, and Utah State has pushed back here. Now tied at 14. Coming up at the half, Northwestern with the stunner over Nebraska. Some national title favorites.
I'm not as stunned as others.
Really?
No. In Dublin, Ireland, who knows what's going to happen out there? James Joyce might start taking snaps.
The Huskers took over the town. At least what we were saying, it was about 85% Nebraska fans, but thankfully there are plenty of pubs for them to drown their sorrows in. So Utah State looking for their first lead of the ball game.
This is the worst case scenario for UConn, having to defend again at the end of the half.
Play action. Bonner throws near sideline, and Van Leeuwen makes the catch for a first down.
And now that spread is starting to work. You're starting to see more wide open players. Bonner knows exactly what he wants to do with the ball right after he gets it in his hands.
Give him 12 yards. Here's Tyler. And Tyler got a nice block They'll rumble up into UConn territory. Jackson Mitchell again to hand in on the tackle.
And just little mistakes, right? Little attention to detail things that kept UConn from possessing the ball. The illegal touch, the bobble going out of bounds.
After the gain of 9, this will be a first down and more for Tyler. Across the UConn 30, Malik Dixon finally stops him. But now some momentum is being built up by Utah State. A flag comes in late.
Chris Schoen came in and tried to make that tackle, but didn't wrap up like we were talking about earlier. And the bounce off yards were plentiful.
He knocked down his man earlier, but that's not going to cut it.
After the play, unsportsmanlike conduct, number 1 of the defense. That penalty's half the distance to the goal. Automatic first down. This is number 1's first unsportsmanlike foul that counts for disqualification.
There he is, Malik Dixon. What did he do? They pushed him over there. And that's a loss of composure here. This is a very, very critical time for UConn as you start to feel the wheels shaking.
Aggies now over 300 yards for the game.
Happens fast, doesn't it?
It does. Bonner looking end zone, back shoulder, up for grabs. Caught for the touchdown. Justin McGriff in the corner of the end zone. And Utah State has the lead for the first time this afternoon.
A deep corner and a gigantic target in the senior out of Tampa, Florida, 6'6". And Bonner looks at him the whole way after the play fake, floats it beautifully. And let's look at the feet. That foot, the left foot looks like it's in. The officials are both right on it. A late flag comes out on Wortham with the push.
Well, this is what we figured Utah State was capable of. They are going to review this.
The previous play of a touchdown is under further review.
20 unanswered points this quarter for the Aggies, a team that averaged about 33 last year per game.
Just a high arcing ball because of the size advantage Bonner knows that his receiver has. Now, there he is. Touchdown. Perfect shot.
I got him in. You got him in?
Got him in.
Okay.
I mean, I need Dean to make sure.
Just show the replay on the video board here. Justin McGriff, one of the top returning targets for Utah State. There aren't a lot of receivers that are returning. We talked about that already. But he caught 35 passes for 6 touchdowns last year. So I got him in. Petros has him in.
Well, this is a beautiful shot here. You can see the blue. Just a very small amount of blue behind that white cleat. You know, it's not like Kevin McHale with the white shoes at the white three-point line at Boston Garden. We got better shots now. And that was definitive.
3 touchdowns in under 11 minutes for Utah State. And again, they trailed early in a lot of their games last year. And at the half, in 8 of 14.
After reviewing the play, the ruling on the field stands, touchdown.
Well, they have come back from down 14-0 to reestablish some semblance of order here as we approach the end of the half.
Now, if you're UConn, you can't go 3 and out again. I mean, you absolutely cannot. Utah State's got all 3 of their timeouts. You don't want to end up, after the first half had so many positives, down 2 scores going into the locker room.
21-14. Utah State has surged back to take the lead in Logan. UConn opened up a 14-0 lead in this game. But their last 4 drives have not been nearly as good. Fumble and three punts. And look at the difference
wow.
in the second quarter.
Man.
That's the most first half yards for Utah State since 2019. Whoa, Bruton gets lit up on the return. Max Alford. What a shot.
Young man out of Park City, Utah. And as we talked about the Aggies and their way of playing, that attacking style, stacking plays, stacking momentum, special teams is part of that as well. If they can get a three and out here, Logan Bonner's licking his chops.
Oh, yeah, all three timeouts still. They are plenty capable. So now the Huskies, who scored two touchdowns in their first three drives of the game. Taquan Roberson, their starting quarterback, has been knocked out. Pitch here to Nathan Carter. He's been their best running back. And Carter, how explosive has he been today?
Did they need that?
Yes, they did. 14 yards and a first down.
A little short toss there to Carter, and he's able to exploit the hole and get a hold of the ball and keep the clock running, most importantly.
Now up over a career high in rushing yards for Carter today.
And up again to number 28. Brian
Bruton gets the call here. Flag comes in. See what this is about. Clock stops at the minute 24 left in the half. Nathan Carter now up over 140 yards rushing today. He said he was a little bit banged up in fall camp. He might get fewer reps today.
There are two fouls on the play, both after the play. Unsportsmanlike conduct, number six, defense, number seven, offense. Those penalties will offset. This is the first unsportsmanlike for both individuals. That counts towards disqualification.
Something to keep an eye on. We had the unsportsmanlike with UConn defensively. Oh, the old receiver DB
fight. Correction five for the offense.
I was doing that to Alex right before the game. It got a little chippy.
You were. That's old, our warm-up routine.
Yeah, the old forefinger.
Yes. Except I'm wearing glasses. At least that need protection. All right. Clock restarts. Approaching a minute to go in the half. And Turner stumbles behind the line. Timeout for Utah State.
Greshit caused that. He stayed home, didn't buy the fake, and was right in the face of Zion Turner when he completed the fake. And there was nowhere for
timeout,
him to go but
Utah
down.
Utah State's their first of the half. This is a 30-second timeout.
Loss of four.
Watch Greshit. Does not come down at all. And that puts Turner in a bind. Another big third down.
I mean, this is UConn started out 3 for 5. They've not converted their last two third downs.
The third down game for UConn offensively has really consisted of a lot of screens.
Yep.
Trying to get the ball to the backs.
I wonder if it would have been different had Roberson still been in the game.
Well, they'll be writing about that in UConn tomorrow, yep, perhaps, but not easy to go into a place like this and face that kind of adversity, losing your starting quarterback early, but Zion Turner's been pretty good as a true freshman.
UConn was the worst team in FBS football on third down last year, and they're not going to convert this one. Houston lit up in the backfield, A.J. Vompachon and Byron Vaughn's both there. And with 61 seconds left in the half and two timeouts for Utah State,
timeout,
the Huskies
Utah
will punt.
Utah State, their second of the half.
Pretty safe
call. This is a 30-second timeout.
For UConn, but way too much penetration there from Byron Vaughns, the junior who started his career at Texas as a Longhorn. Guy out of Fort Worth. Makes a nice play. Teammates are there to clean it up for him. Logan Bonner's got another chance in the first half. Who would have known the way this game started?
You tempt fates. That might happen. The Huskies with two turnovers this half. This one, they'll punt back to Utah State. We'll have one timeout and a little under a minute to work with. Awfully close to a delay of game. Cooper Jones back to receive. About the 43-yard line, it will take a Utah State hop. And it'll be a short field, 52 seconds after a 27-yard punt. And one timeout for the Aggies to try to build on this lead.
Well, the Aggies can smell that blood in the water, and they have started to get that offense rolling forward. And once it starts rolling downhill, it's awful hard to stop. The Huskies have got to find one iota of the juice they had in the first quarter to find a way to regroup in the locker room and not give up more points here.
Utah State starting on the plus side of midfield. Run play is blown up. Calvin Tyler got the call and went nowhere. Loss of one, Marquez Bembry.
And good linebacker play from UConn most of all this half, and that's a good start for them.
Bonner, two-step drop, wide open far sideline. Brian Cobbs turns up field, has a first down. Clock will stop to move the chains, 28 seconds.
Miles Bell had about 12 yards of cushion on Cobbs there. Unbelievably wide open for Bonner.
19 yards on the completion. Clock moves once again, about 20 seconds remaining. Bonner takes off, slides, and calls timeout.
Good awareness. That's a experienced quarterback. Slides right in front of Bembry. Gets up and knows exactly what he has to do. Look at this cushion. I mean, I know Cobbs is good, but check out Miles Bell just in a full bail technique. And so much room to work for Cobbs. And you got your Aggies offense threatening again.
Final timeout taken with 16 seconds. And the ball at the UConn 28. Well within field goal range, should it come down to that. But the Aggies, I agree. This is their style, smelling blood in the water, a team that starting to fatigue on the other side, starting to become a little bit rattled on the road.
And we've seen it in all three phases.
Yeah.
Defensively, special teams, stacking success, and attacking. That is Blake Anderson's style, and it's caught fire in the Mountain West. They've been successful since he's shown up.
I'm sure there are Alabama fans who are watching this game. That's where Utah State will be next week. We looked at the first quarter and said, whoa, this could be easy pickings, but
maybe feel like they can run the ball.
Yeah, well, that still may be the case, but we'll see. Bonner, that was miscommunication or just throwing it away. Facing some pressure.
You know, he's got one more shot at the end zone.
Clock stops at 10 seconds, third down and 9. Would you go across the middle here and see if you can spike it? Or do you run?
They're pretty good at playing fast, but I think he's going to throw this one to the end zone. Nope.
Now they'll throw it incomplete. Not sure where that was supposed to be. There was a man, Kyle Van Leeuwen, in the end zone, but was not targeted. And with 6 seconds left in the half, Utah State will attempt a field goal here.
They're so sophisticated offensively that a lot of these reads change after the snap. That time, Bonner was on a different page than Van Leeuwen. Van Leeuwen wanted the end zone. Bonner wanted him to hold up and spike it like you wanted.
Yeah. Yeah. I don't know. From our vantage point, it seems pretty easy, right? Everything seems easy.
That altitude will get you there.
Yeah, yes. This will be a 45-yard attempt for Connor Coles. 6 of 11 for his career from this range. Line drive and through. And the Aggies lead 24-14 with 1 second remaining in the half. Well, 24 unanswered points, but it was not a good start for the Aggies by any means on either side of the ball.
Well, I think Coach Mora's game plan, the two different quarterbacks, the aggressive running style, the great linebacker play defensively, I think that put the Aggies on their heels a little bit early. But like you said, Alex, they played from behind a whole bunch. They're very comfortable knowing that they can come back quickly in a game. Obviously, they love playing at home in this altitude. And Coach Mora's got a lot of talking to do at halftime to keep his team's confidence up.
Yeah. Well, last year, Utah State rallied from down double digits 6 times to win en route to an 11-3 season, 7-2 Mountain West. And they begin this season receiving votes in the AP poll. Last year, 3 teams in the state of Utah finished ranked in the final AP poll. And this team, UConn, is on the long road back to respectability.
Well, you can really argue that Utah in Salt Lake and, of course, the Aggies and Logan are experiencing the best football in their history.
Yeah.
The most consistent and best. And, of course, BYU's been a mainstay for years. The Beehive State is alive with football.
125th season of Utah State football. Got off to a rocky start, but 24 unanswered points for the Aggies. And they are back in business. Leading by 10 at the half, we'll join Rob Stone in the studio for our State Farm halftime right after this. Petros Papadakis here with you. Second half moments away. You thought you were going to ease into week zero, didn't you?
I did. I thought it was going to be a nice, easy transition.
Hey, what a back-and-forth game. Utah State approaching 350 total yards of offense. What stands out to you first half so far?
Well, really, what stood out to me was the turning point in the game. This fumble after a nice, big, strong run by Nathan Carter, and things just really started to fall apart after UConn came in with such a physical showing. Bonner finally got the offense moving, finding Van Leeuwen in little pockets within the UConn zone. And we saw some really physical running from the freshman, Robert Briggs. And that kind of changed the game. Bonner was able to get his confidence going. He found Justin McGriff, the 6'6 receiver. And it doesn't look like the Aggies have slowed down since last year. UConn with a new identity, but losing a little bit of their composure there in the second quarter.
That fumble came with 14 minutes and 18 seconds left in the quarter. It was a 19-yard run. Would have been more for Carter. But the ball was stripped. Utah State scored on the ensuing possession. And they finished the half with 24 unanswered points. And Nathan Carter, that one fumble loss looms large in changing the momentum in this game.
And it changed the play calling
as
well. And what UConn was able to do, kind of possessing the ball and eating the clock, that's the kind of football you play when you have a lead. They don't have that anymore, but they do have is the ball coming to them, because they did get a stop to start the game and march right down and score.
So UConn will have the ball to begin the second half. They won the toss and deferred. Devontae Houston is back along with Brian Burton. And the ball dropped initially by Burton. He picks it back up. searches for a lane and motors up near the 30-yard line. He gets hit hard along the sideline. A little jawing there from Gervon Hall, the Miami transfer. Bruton is, as we talked about earlier, a lethal kickoff return man if he gets a crease.
The one he took back against Clemson last year, he fumbled as well.
Yeah,
gets
that's
him
right.
started.
Right.
That's a pretty good return. We'll see what the freshman, Zion Turner, who was forced into action after Taquan Robinson, Rob Roberson went down in the first half.
Yeah, we saw Roberson chatting. It was a nice moment with Blake Anderson, the head coach of Utah State, and with Logan Bonner. He's on crutches. So it is Turner's game for the moment. And here's Nathan Carter. Man, there have been some gaping holes created by this offensive line, and Carter has exploited them. Injured player for Utah State.
Yeah, that's a Johnny Carter who just went down. He's one of the better corners in the Mountain West, but that's what Carter has kind of brought to this game, a punishing running style, and he's not easy to tackle. Good ball security at the end there by Carter, too, getting both hands on the ball after the fumble that we just watched the replay of. We'll see if Carter, the senior out of Houston, can get up.
Looks like shoulder collarbone area the way he went in on the hit. Still has his helmet on. They're going to help him off the field.
Here comes Carter wearing number 12. And, yeah, that's that shoulder right into the side. Looks like he's swinging it around okay. Carter, an avid bass fisherman and a cowboy of sorts, loves to ride horses. North Shore High School Mustangs in Houston, a great, great program.
Nathan Carter already at a career high, over 150 yards now. And Carter exits. Didn't start a single game last year, but expected to be an impact player this year. Second down and two. And this play goes nowhere. Byron Vaughns, MVP of the Mountain West Championship game on defense last year, comes up with a tackle for loss.
Been very disruptive. They try that quick end around to Aaron Turner, and Vaughns just does not buy it. Right up the field, making the play. And a little bit of a celebration.
Yeah, they've been spoon-feeding those run plays, but now they might have to run a pass play here on third and seven. After the fourth tackle for loss for Utah State, Turner escapes. Turner gets by another would-be tackler and might have enough. Something out of nothing for the freshman, Zion Turner.
He's kind of been stumbling when he takes off, but an inside route there. Chase Lunt badly beaten, and that forces Turner to the outside, and a little bit of a fake throw and some nifty feet. Way to stay on the field for the freshman. They needed that.
9 yards, enough for the first.
Third down has been an adventure for the Huskies.
Yeah. They have four conversions. Carter taken down to midfield. There's Vaughns again on the tackle.
Nathan Carter was limited in camp, but he seems to be running very well here as the game goes on. Really nice vision getting right back up underneath MJ Tavisi, who's had a lot of tackles today. The Mike backer, but that time he out-leveraged him. Nice 7-yard gain to open up that series.
I mean, in one game today, he might get close to about a third of his production from all of last season.
First down is huge for them. They have to get yardage on first down to manage it for the quarterback.
Speaking of, a throw to the near side. A little contact along the sideline. Brian Bruton, the intended target. Byron Vaughns in coverage. He's been everywhere this series. A.J. Vompichon there as well.
They've been trying to exploit the backs out of the backfield, throwing the ball to him, make it a little easier for Turner, and trying to take advantage of how aggressive the linebackers and the edge players are for Utah State. Try to slip somebody out wide open. Good coverage that time by Vaughns.
Third down and three. UConn 4 for 9 on third down today. Stood up behind the line of scrimmage. A.J. Vompichon along with Kaleo Nives. Fourth down.
Bonk Pachon is their runner and their hitter. He comes a little late on the play. Byron Bonds is there. I understand the play call. You finally got a manageable third down. You try to run it and get it with your back. Nice job of bowing up by the Aggies defense, forcing a punt.
Problem was their number one back had checked out of the game, was on the sideline for it. So the Huskies will punt to begin the second half. A fair catch at the 8-yard line for Cooper Jones. Utah State's defense struggled to begin the game, but they've come to life just as the offense has. 24-14 to the Aggies. Logan Bonner and the Utah State Aggies, who have scored 24 unanswered. Bonner now has thrown for just a bit under 200 yards on the day. Calvin Tyler Jr., their number one back, and Kyle Van Leeuwen, three catches for 54 yards.
A lot of talk about who's going to take over at the wide receiver position. Van Leeuwen's been good. Cobbs has made plays. And McGriff with a big touchdown catch and a whole second half to get this offense working again.
Tyler, who had four 100-yard rushing games last year. This is a swing pass to Cobbs, and he is met right away. Tackled for a loss. Beg your pardon, it's Nine Eye Davis on the reception. And Caleb Anthony with the tackle. They had that run in earlier in the game, remember? Pointing fingers.
That's right. Caleb Anthony, great job getting to his legs and making sure he wasn't able to break the tackle. Nice start of the drive by UConn. See if they can keep them backed up here. Not easy.
And off to Tyler. And he'll get three or four. Colin McCarthy with the tackle, and it's quickly third down.
This would be huge for the Huskies to be able to get off the field, even though they haven't been in control of this game for some time. They are still close.
This is a pretty young defensive line for UConn, but they've held their own.
They've been pretty impressive defensively against a real buzzsaw today.
Meyer dropping back, looking to pass near sideline. Griff was turned around somehow in front of the ball and made the catch.
This is how they take your heart. You got a third and long situation you fought so hard for. Trey Wortham, a little bit beat on the line of scrimmage. McGriff so big, safety late coming over. Nice throw.
29 yards and sets up Tyler to get a nice run on first down. Pickup of eight.
And now you see the ball start to roll downhill. That's the real trigger for this Aggies offense is chunk plays, and they just build on that.
They want to work quickly, but we have a whistle here on a false start.
False start, number 72, offense. 5-yard penalty, second down.
That's one way to kill momentum from the honorable mention, all-conference left tackle Alfred Edwards. He's been a starter at Utah State for 3-plus years.
Looks like some of the Aggies were complaining about the UConn defense giving dummy signals as to why they jumped off sides, but usually takes a couple times for the refs to pick that up.
Play clock down to five. Tyler. Wrapped up. It'll be another third down at the 45-yard line. Jackson Mitchell again on the tackle.
He's been productive throughout this game. Really coming through in the first half for his team.
Bonner on third and four. He had McGriff across the middle. Perhaps he overthrew him, but yeah, Jackson Mitchell there, draped all over him as well. And it's fourth down.
Hard to miss that guy. And he stretched his body right across the middle, but that ball just a little bit outside his range. It looked as if Bonner wanted him to come a little further across.
The Aggies are going to punt here. this UConn defense is holding their own. So all the way out of the back of the end zone. The game would have been a decent punt. So, the Huskies still within arm's reach, down by 10 on the road. Jim Mora at the helm. This UConn Huskies team, and boy, what a tough sight for his starting quarterback to go down in the first quarter of their season opener. Chad on the sideline with Taquan Roberson, the Penn State transfer. Appeared in just five games over his career coming in, but he has been a really strong leader. What all the coaches tell us with his Huskies team. Now in the hands of Zion Turner as he throws incomplete here on first down.
Good decisive move.
Yeah.
Trying to get it to Dixon, but knocked down at the line of scrimmage, it looked like. Turner only 5'11", and it doesn't look like he has that high of a release point. So on short dropbacks, he's going to be susceptible to that type of thing.
It's been mostly Turner. Cale Millen saw a couple of snaps after Roberson was injured on the second play of the second drive for UConn today. A pass here and connect with Kevin Sclercius. And the Montreal native rumbles to about the 34-yard line. 13-yard pickup, first down for the Huskies.
Good-looking kind of outside screen action from Coach Charlton, the OC. And well done by Clarcius to read his blockers and find a little crease there to get the first down. They've got to string a lot more of that together to get this freshman's confidence going and to get back into this game. It looks like we have Christian Haynes down out of Bowie, Maryland, a right guard.
Who Nick Charlton told us was their best offensive lineman. So sub out.
He is their guy, and they've played pretty well on the offensive line. When they've been able to run the ball, they've gotten a really good push, but you're not up against an offense that is very merciful when it comes to keeping pace.
And off to Bruton as he cuts to his left. Bruton made another move and gets to about the 40-yard line, setting up a second and short.
Just 5'7", but man, he gets every inch of himself going when he runs the ball. Just all his limbs, his whole body, there's a lot of suddenness in the way he goes upfield, and that's a nice run on first down. Looks a little bit like UConn did in the first quarter.
Carter back in the game for the Huskies. And a little misdirection here. Dejon Harrison has the first down. Gets knocked out hard by Gervon Hall, who's had a couple of run-ins there. Nearly ran over that lineman who was prone on the sideline.
Zion Turner thought he was probably going to watch this game from the sideline. Now he's on a reverse. Woo-hoo. Look at that block by the young quarterback. A great job cleaning up, getting Von Pichon down.
That's where they were treating Christian Haynes, the lineman. He nearly just got run over. But you're right, that's a heck of a block for the freshman. First down for the Huskies. Turner looking, throwing, caught at the 40 of Utah State. Aaron Turner wanted to move upfield. He had turned the corner, lost his footing. A gain of 20, a first down as Turner gets knocked down after releasing the ball.
Yeah, Turner with a little bit of a limp, but he's moving back to the line of scrimmage. Nice throw. Looks like he's comfortable throwing the ball on the move. Von Pichon with the hit, and it looked like he kind of got crumpled under, but able to recover. They're really spreading it around here. We've seen Harrison carry the ball here.
Last year, the Huskies only had a 24% passing success rate. Much better this year, and a huge hit by MJ Tafisi, blowing up the run play.
Tafisi, the Washington transfer. Mike Backer. He Utah native from Jordan, Utah, out to high school hawk. Makes one of the most physical plays of the day. Popped his head like a rock'em sock'em robot right there in the hole.
One of four impact transfers on defense for Utah State. No gain, second down. Turner. It's probably for the best, but that didn't line up in the hands of Clarcius, and it is ruled an incomplete pass. Third down.
Trying to get the ball out of the young quarterback's hand, help him make decisions. It's worked out about half the time. But overall, I think if you're Jim Mora and you look at Zion Turner, you feel pretty good. He came out and immediately started competing and did not implode even after his first pass was an interception. And here he is moving him along again, but another third and long has been hard for them, Alex.
Turner throws across his body, deflected, incomplete. And Utah State's defense will force a punt. Ike Larson in on the play for the Aggies.
And I tell you, Nick Charlton and Jim Mora must have been holding their breath when Larson had a shot at that ball. Turner over there trying to direct traffic, throwing that back across his body. Dangerous area for a young quarterback to be throwing it, but Utah State able to at least punt it and try to pin the Aggies back like they did on the last possession.
And after those 14 early points, this is now the sixth straight punt for UConn. Play clock all the way down, and they'll call the delay of game.
A game, number 13, offense. 5-yard penalty, fourth down.
Huskies looking for a little room there. See if the Aggies will give it to him.
Blake Anderson was signaling he wanted to decline the penalty. So the Huskies punt here. Let's see if they can pin him.
Drama.
How close can you get? The down to punt at the half yard line.
Some of the busiest rhymes ever made by man are going into this mic written by this hand.
That close. Little shred of green. And that's the difference between a touchback and starting with your quarterback halfway into your own end zone.
In the shotgun. That's modern football.
Never in your day.
Not there. Or on the other goal line.
Tyler able to escape his own end zone. Dragged down by his right foot. Who else? Jackson Mitchell, who's approaching a career high in tackles, already in the double digits.
Well, we said his thing was production tackling, and that's come to fruition for sure. Little more room for the Aggies now.
Game two, here's Tyler again. And Tyler pushes the pile all the way to the 8-yard line, setting up a third manageable. Utah State, a program that 2 years ago had just one victory. And so that's why a game like this feels uncomfortable. Because last year they were able to run roughshod over their opposition on many a night, even after early deficits. Tyler has enough.
You've seen Tyler carrying the ball more and more, 3-4 times in a row in this game, and that was not available last year for the Oregon State transfer. Tough to play in the altitude. And they say this year he's really got it going.
Start to say there he's over 100 yards now for the afternoon. Gets another call here as a flag comes in. Tyler at a career-high 26 carries for 120 yards and a touchdown in the bowl win over his former team, Oregon State, last year.
Holding, number 69, offense. Penalties half the distance to the goal. Replay first down.
Felipe Alo, the junior center.
He can play both guard positions and center. As a swing man, he's created a lot of depth for this Aggie team. They get him with the hold there, but still first down.
New back into the game, it's Makakona, who had the early mishap, the fumble. Was punched away by Jackson, actually ripped away by Jackson Mitchell early in the game.
Maybe the best defensive play of the game thus far individually by Jackson Mitchell. Makakona able to get his hands back on the ball again. After a fumble in the first game of the year, usually it takes about a quarter and a half for them to give it to you again.
You mentioned the altitude. This drive, the way that Utah State's approached it. As Makakona gets the call again, spins away for the first wave and is brought down at the 15-yard line. Strikes me as one of those where you are playing at altitude and you're trying to keep the defense on the field, wear them down, and then go for the big play.
That's been the case. We've seen it a couple of run plays. There appears to be a lull, and then Bonner drops back, and that ball's out immediately, whether it's to Van Leeuwen or McGriff or somebody else. Here's that moment, and they're all spread out ready for it.
Makakona in the backfield on third down. He'll block for Bonner, who throws, and it's batted away. Justin McGriff, the intended target, and Ian Swenson, who, remember, took that hard shot to his shoulder, collarbone area earlier in the first half, in on the coverage.
They brought a bunch of guys. Swenson there to make the hit. Wortham over the top. Looked like a good enough window for McGriff to make that play, but the timing wasn't there, and UConn forces another punt. They're hanging around here in the third quarter.
Flying drive punt. That will hop and skip well in the Husky territory. Again, this Huskies team, you said it, Petros, they're hanging. Trey Wortham doing his part. Husky ball next. All right, the number one most watched regular season window in all of college football is Big Noon Saturday, and it is back on September 10th. It doesn't get bigger. The number one Alabama versus Texas. Start every Saturday with Big Noon kickoff. And then the day's best matchup. It all starts September 10th, all season long here on Fox. So if you like to tell a big story, weave it all together, right? Utah State will face Alabama next week. Alabama on to Texas. Right? All ties together. And this Utah State defense has certainly improved as the day has gone along. Patrick Joyner Jr., the Miami transfer, coming up with a tackle for loss here. Utah State has forced seven straight punts from UConn.
You think they'll do that to Bama? And Bryce Young versus Bonner?
I'm not going to go that far. Don't see that.
They've certainly taken control of the game with their defense. UConn's been unable to build upon their success in the first quarter. And maybe part of that is the quarterback situation.
Now seven tackles for loss for Utah State, but there goes Carter. It's been a hard man to wrap up. Another big run for Carter, who has destroyed a career high today and has a first down for UConn.
He's been a big bright spot, the sophomore out of Rochester, New York. I like the way he's finished his runs, kept his legs going. The costly fumble in the first half, no doubt about that, but he's continued to carry the mail for the Huskies, and he's had that cross hanging out the whole time. I keep worrying somebody's going to rip it off, take his chain.
Carter up to 175 yards in the afternoon. First down at the Utah State, at the UConn 42. That's awfully close.
Awfully close, but he threw it away forward.
Yeah.
Dangerous, but effective and awkward. This play blew up from the start. They're just not getting the edge protection. Greshick is in the backfield. Makes it very hard for Turner to work after these play fakes. The second he looks up, there's pressure on him.
A.J. Carter back into the game after taking a stunner earlier. Second down and 10. And a sidearm delivery is batted down at the line of scrimmage. Byron Vaughns got a hand in there.
Second time we've seen that this quarter.
Different arm slot from Turner.
Different arm slot, and he's not that tall anyway. So, you know, that's coming at like 5'7".
Yeah.
Byron Vaughns, 6'4", 225. Math.
Sometimes not my strong suit. Throw on third down. Carter slips through a tackle. He's been impossible to drag down today. Hunter Reynolds finally got to him.
Well, they're taking advantage of these edge rushers. Greshick is flying up the field, and that leaves a big hole for Carter to exploit, and Vongpachon can't get over there in time and make the play, and UConn with a conversion.
That's the seventh run of 10 or more yards for Nathan Carter today, the sophomore from Rochester, New York. Having a career outing, nearing 200 yards, and from his back foot, Zion Turner, that's a dangerous throw off his back foot. Flag comes in late. Kaleo Neves with the tackle as we enter the final minute of the third quarter.
Nick Charlton with some really complex screen calls in this game. That was a double screen.
Personal foul, face mask, number 23, defense. Grabbing the helmet opening. It's a 15-yard penalty. First down.
So Bruton had a good chance to catch this and get up underneath some of the blocking. He doesn't because Neves is there, but Neves unable to make the tackle without the penalty. You see Noel Ofori-Niagu out there, and he just couldn't make the block, but it doesn't matter either way because of the penalty.
That's a costly penalty.
I didn't see him really grab much of the opening.
Yeah. First down for the Huskies. And they'll keep it on the ground again. Meeting resistance this time from Motuapuaka. Alain Motuapuaka is a senior from Hawaii. Singled out as the father figure of the defensive tackles.
And a three-time World Fire Knife Competition champion.
Have you ever competed in that, Petros? That strikes me as something you would do.
Fire knife?
Yeah, what you have, like, yeah, why not? Well, hey, we got ourselves a ball game. Leave that chit-chat for later. Scoreless third quarter. It's a 10-point game as we head to the fourth. The Huskies hanging on, driving downfield here as we start the fourth. Reach out of the Wasatch front. A warm summer's afternoon, late August, in Logan, Utah. 24 unanswered for Utah State after they fell behind 14-0 to a UConn team that went 1-11 in 2021, the defending champions of the Mountain West Conference. They've had an uncomfortable outing this afternoon, and UConn not done yet, driving into Utah State territory. Here's a catch for Kevin Clercius as the ball is knocked out late. He'll pick up about 3 yards and set up a third and long.
Not giving up any points here in the third quarter. That's what's kept UConn relevant here as we begin the fourth. And after that penalty, a great opportunity for them. Ajani Carter back in the game, the bass fishing cornerback. After
the
awkward
knives.
Tackle.
He seems meaner.
What? Yeah.
The guy with the knives.
Third down and seven.
Exactly, third down and seven.
A lot of lot of diverse hobbies, Utah State team.
Pitch out of the backfield. That's interesting. On third down, going to Devontae Houston. And it doesn't work. Winds up with UConn faced in a fourth down situation. And a long field goal attempt here. Noe Rulis, who is essentially the backup place kicker for UConn. Joe McFadden, who's pretty decent for them, out with the torn ACL. And so the sophomore from West Hartford, Connecticut, will attempt a 46-yard field goal. This guy was a record holder in high school in Connecticut for distance. And he knocks this one through from 46 to make it a one-score game.
Big moment for UConn fighting back in this game.
Huskies drive downfield and come away with points. 24-17, Utah State. A team receiving votes in the AP poll. Given some trouble here by the FBS Independent, the UConn Huskies.
Well, look at that ring in his nose bouncing around.
He fell over. He tumbled around. And the students, they were all rushing the field. I guess they were able to bring the students on earlier. It's a hard fall. I'm surprised the nose ring stayed in. And this will be a touchback. Can't say too many bad things about the Utah State offense. 404 total yards of offense. Logan Bonner's been fine. 15 of 22 for 218. And a couple of touchdowns.
And when they watch the tape, they're going to see a lot of missed opportunities, I'm sure. They're going to say they should have played a lot better. The fourth quarter, though, will end up telling the tale on how they feel about themselves when this one's over and they head out to Tuscaloosa.
And it may very well just be the 30-point mark. That was the magic number last year. They were 7-0 when scoring 30 or more points. The top offense is in the Mountain West last season. Tyler weaving his way through the traffic. Gets about 3 yards on first down before meeting resistance. Chris Sheeran, Missouri transfer, on the tackle. And Brandon Boyer-Randall's been a physical presence for UConn today. Second down and 7.
Bounce foot.
Terrell Vaughn in motion. Hand it off to Tyler again. And he gets about 2. Are you surprised at all with the pace that Utah State's going at?
They've really wanted to run the ball on first or second down and kind of try to grind it out. I think they think they're going to gash him on one of these plays, but UConn's been pretty stout. They have a bit of a scrum going on there. No flags, though, I don't see. Looks like Dalmont Gordine is upset there. But UConn keeps creating these third down situations that Logan Bonner's got to figure out.
Third and 5. From the 30, Bonner dropping back and delivers a dime to Calvin Tyler. Ball comes out. Huskies were on top of it at first, still available. Who's got it? It pumps free, and UConn has it. Chris Sheeran finally winds up on top of the football after a mad scramble.
What a play.
UConn ball.
First, Logan Bonner doing a great job getting the ball out to his back and baiting Eric Watts into kind of no man's land, but a flying tackle by Trey Wortham. Really forcing that ball out, put his helmet right on the ball, and then, Alex, it's chaos in the Wasatch.
What a turn of events.
Yeah, it's tough down there when you're holding the ball. Everybody tries to grab every other part of you, so you let go of the ball.
Second time that Utah State has lost a fumble. It was Makakona in the first quarter, punched out by Jackson Mitchell. This time just a physical tackle that jars the ball loose.
And what can UConn do offensively with the freshman quarterback Zion Turner to find a way to get some points on the board. Relatively short field here.
Turner's only completed 9 passes today. Nathan Carter's been the star, 184 yards, and he lines up in the backfield here. Turner drops back to pass, throws, sideline, and reeled in. What a catch by Kevin Clarcius. 9 yards for Clarcius on first down.
Clarcius, who seemed to change his number in the middle of the game, doing a great job falling down and getting back up and tracking that ball.
Just 20 catches all of last season for Clarcius. And here's Carter. So elusive. He has a first down for the Huskies.
I've been impressed with Carter throughout this game. He's kept coming. This is high altitude. I know we've been harping on that, but it's very true. If you've ever walked up the stairs in high altitude, you know. And he is coming hard, 190 yards already, and he's still punishing that D in the fourth quarter.
Turner gets rid of it, pays the price, and it's incomplete. Jacob Flynn, the intended target. Byron Vaughns brought the heat.
And you can tell that Coach Mora and his OC, Nick Charlton, are really trying to avoid those deep drop backs where Turner has the ball in his hands and he's having to go through progression. Bit of an adventure with the young quarterback, but they have to like the way they keep competing.
Well, they know he has the raw arm strength. That's big picture what they have with Turner. But in the moment, a true freshman trying to navigate this difficult environment. Vaughns brings him down, and it's third down at about 9.
Showing a little bit of a zone read look to try to confuse the Aggies. Haven't seen much of that at all in this game. And here's another third and long. What will UConn do? So many sophisticated screens they've called already. Some successful, some not.
Huskies 5 for 13 on third down. And a long one here with Turner looking, throwing out of play. Nearly picked off by Vaughns. Ike Larson chasing down the quarterback. And the Huskies, let's see what they set up here.
And they brought the extra guy. You know, they brought Ike Larson, and he really screwed up the timing for Turner on that play. And yeah, he's off the field, Alex. That's that. They're going to kick it. Plenty of time. 7-point game.
Go for a field goal here.
All right.
This is going to be a long one. 54 yards. Rulis hit a 56-yarder in high school. He's already hit from 46 today. And in the altitude, he's going to drill this from 54.
Might have been good from 64.
Mm.
Wow.
And it's just a 4-point game with just over. Well, after Randy Edsall resigned early last season, what was going to happen to this independent UConn football program? Athletic director David Benedict was put in touch with Jim Mora, trying to create what they are terming a Husky revolution. They have certainly impressed in this opener, trailing 24-20. The Utah State offense has been pretty much held at bay by this UConn defense. Second half, Petros, 88 yards allowed. Just 2 first downs, 0 points for the Aggies.
And kicking that long field goal right there, Alex, that tells me that Jim Mora trusts this defense. They've been playing great this second half. They've made some really good adjustments, and they're out there frustrating one of the best offenses in the country with one of the most experienced quarterbacks in the country.
So the Aggies looking for something here. Near side, a catch made by Brian Cobbs. Escaped the first tackle, but not the second. Cobbs, however, able to move the chains after a gain of 11.
Now after that first down momentum, this is where the Aggies can hurt you. Building upon that momentum, UConn's been able to stem the tide more often than not.
Robert Briggs down the physical tackle by Malik Dixon, or check that, Brandon Boyer Randall on the tackle. A little tempo here for the first time in a while. Briggs again. And he somersaults his way all the way up to midfield, gain of 7.
Looked like he got the best of Malik Dixon there on that collision, and Dixon is down. Briggs has really been one of the most successful offensive players for the Aggies in this game. Physical running, not a big guy. Just 5'6", 175-pound freshman. And his debut with the Aggies has been exciting. There you see him standing next to John Gentry, who is out with a hamstring, the junior, a more experienced player, helping out the young guy with water and a towel.
Dixon back to his feet. Looked like he took a foot to the helmet or something along those lines. First down for Utah State at midfield. 9.5 to go, and just a 4-point lead. Cut back there from Briggs. Still on his feet, Briggs finally hauled down after a pickup of about a dozen. Flags come in late.
This guy runs very physically, a lot more than what he weighs.
Yeah. He's listed at 5'6", 175.
Fabulous leg drive there. Ran right through Sheeran.
Freshman, about third on the depth chart. Let's check the penalty here.
After the play, personal foul, unnecessary roughness, number 56, offense. That's a 15-yard penalty. It'll be first and 10 after a 15-yard penalty. First down.
Cole Motes. There he is, 56. You see him hunting around the pile, and that will get you. He hits Sheeran. That will get you a penalty every time, and that's a mistake that could really cost the Aggies depending on what happens here.
12-yard gain negated by a 15-yard penalty. Sideline, tiptoeing the line was Cobbs, makes the catch at the 45. Gain of 8.
You see how fast Bonner wants to play, frustrated with the officials.
Oh, another fumble. This one, he's going to be ruled down. Robert Briggs, awfully close to the third fumble of the game for Utah State.
Freshman mistake to reach that ball, Alex, especially not near the goal line or in a short yardage situation. I mean, the knees weren't down, but it looks like the ground and the elbow went down when the ball came out. That was a lot closer than I believe it looked originally.
It's enough for a first down. Ball to the sideline. Justin McGriff was about 2 yards out of the UConn sideline.
Yeah, a lot of guys working on the white today.
Yeah, exactly, mingling with the bench there.
But that happens a lot with Utah State because their splits with their receivers are so incredibly wide, yeah. And that's part of the offense that they run.
4 first downs on this drive for Utah State. These linemen starting to breathe heavily now. You mentioned it, when you're at altitude, you don't feel like you're short of air. Just everything burns.
Dalmont Gordine right there, huffing and puffing, but UConn's defense has come up throughout this second half.
Play action. Bonner brought down. Who else but Jackson Mitchell? His first sack of the ball game. And he's right at a career high in tackles. It has been a terrific afternoon for the junior from Ridgefield, Connecticut.
Bonner's pretty nifty with his feet, but Mitchell just such a good tackler and so long. Able to get him down there and create a third and long situation. Husky's got to find a way to get off the field here.
Bonner on third and long takes a shot. it's broken up. Flag on the play.
Caleb Anthony, kind of awkward there. That was a different kind of ball that was thrown to where everybody had to adjust to it.
Pass interference, number 5, defense. It's a 15-yard penalty from the previous spot. Results, a first down.
Anthony thought he was pushed off on. Let's take a look here. Bonner tested him deep. It's Anthony versus Van Leeuwen. He gets his head around. I just don't see it there. If he had his head facing Van Leeuwen, the old face guarding call, which doesn't even exist anymore, that draws the flag a lot. But his head was around, and I didn't see a lot of contact.
So on 3rd and 12, they're bailed out with a PI call. As Tyler looks to turn the corner, picks up 3 on 1st down. Ian Swenson on the stop. Chris Sheeran had a hand in as well. 2nd down.
I mean, we've seen setback after setback that these Huskies have faced. And they've been able to overcome it. You know, not giving up points in this second half has been one heck of a feat thus far. But
honestly,
could be changing soon here.
It's been impressive to watch. Had to dump it off short. Parker Buchanan, and it reaches shoelaces. Incompletes, 3rd and 6.
They've just done a great job of disrupting Bonner and keeping him somewhat out of rhythm. Nice pressure that time from Bembry. There you see Mitchell, who's just been a superstar. Another 3rd down.
And Logan Bonner summons something here after setting 5 single-season school records in passing last year. 3rd down and 6 from the 24. He'll shovel it to Tyler. And Tyler has the 1st down. Calvin Tyler Jr., the transfer from Oregon State, picks up a dozen. And a massive play to keep the drive going for Utah State.
They spread you out so far. 3 wide receivers already all the way to the sideline on one side, 1 to the other, and you hit him up the middle with a shovel pass. Nice play call by Blake Anderson's offense.
Spreading him out again on 1st down with Tyler in the backfield.
I mean, look how wide that is. Look how much of the field they make you defend.
Approaching 6.5 to go. 1st down for the Aggies. Tyler right up the gut for a couple. And does UConn's defense have one more stop in them? They've held the Aggies scoreless this half.
That PI penalty was a real killer and questionable.
Play action. Looking, throwing, end zone! Caught for the touchdown! Brian Cobbs!
You can't keep giving opportunities to a guy like Logan Bonner. They run a really complex, beautiful 2-man game there with Van Leeuwen. Cobbs comes open right at the corner. Perfectly delivered ball. And Utah State finally getting on the board here in the second half. 6 minutes left in the game. It took them that long.
First of the season for Cobbs, who had just 2 all of last year. And the 5th-year senior transferring in from Maryland, making an impact late. 11 yards for the score, 13 plays, 75-yard drive. And crucially, a little over 4 minutes of the clock. And with 6 minutes to go, it's once again a 2-possession game with the Aggies up by double digits. Back in Logan, 31-20, Utah State. Key play on that last drive for the Aggies, the pass interference call. It was 3rd and 12 at the 43-yard line. Just in the fringes, likely outside of field goal range. Probably would have punted. Instead, it's back to a 2-possession lead for Utah State. See what the Huskies can do here. Houston. Nice blocking from Houston. And a terrific return, setting up a short field for the Huskies. 30 yards on the return.
You feel kind of like this is what they're going to need to get all the way back in this game. A return, maybe some kind of turnover, a trick play. You just wonder if the UConn offense has enough firepower to score the touchdown necessary, or the two touchdowns necessary. But you could do some math there, 2 points, 3 points. They're running out of time with the way their offense has been. There's no doubt about that. Maybe a return, some kind of turnover can change things. The young quarterback, though valiant, has struggled a bit.
Turner just 9 of 25 this afternoon, but he fits one into a tight window there. Clarcius with a catch, and he pays the price. Hard hit by Mike Anyanwu. First down for the Huskies. And that'll work quickly. This one is batted down before it can reach Flynn. Anyanwu, that time, got the better of it.
Let's see if Turner just stares him down. He doesn't. He looks downfield first and then comes out to the edge for his receiver. Just really well defended by Anyanwu, senior out of Covina, California.
Clock stops with 5:42 to go. Second down. There's a completion across the middle to Aaron Turner. Setting up a third. And manageable.
More decisive from Turner in this drive. Getting rid of the ball, getting it out faster. They're going to need that sense of urgency throughout the game.
Looks like he's been learning on the fly in this game. Low snap. Turner slings it sidearm and again has Turner. This time for a first down.
Turner's got to find a way to stay up and catch that ball and keep running. The last one was a little bit off, but that one, to keep your feet under you.
Under 5 minutes to go, first down for the Huskies. Turner airs it out, incomplete. Intended for Clarcius. Anyanwu on coverage.
Double coverage, plenty of help from the safety there. Lucky for Turner, that ball was a little too far for anybody to catch. I really think Nick Charlton's did a great job calling plays in this game for UConn, considering that they lost their quarterback so early, and this true freshman is out there taking him home.
Turner to his right, picked off. Ike Larson.
Redshirt freshman out of Smithfield, Utah. Larson read that the whole way. They called a sprint right option. And that's where the ball's supposed to go. Larson just read it beautifully and made a heck of an athletic play.
First career INT for the redshirt freshman. Does that seal the deal for Utah State?
Here's Ike Larson picking off the young freshman. He recognizes this sprint play right away and just sells out and makes an incredible athletic play on the ball to really probably ice this one. Zion Turner, I don't know where else you throw that ball. That's where they called it. Just a transcendental play by Ike Larson.
Results in the third takeaway of the game for Utah State. I mean, college football is probably the only sport where style points matter in the grand scheme of things. Obviously, in the standings at the end of the season, Mountain West, they won't, but in the rankings for sure.
Look at him just on the move. Had to go full speed for that ball if he was going to make the play, and really stretches out. is to make a great athletic play.
I think Utah State, we know all the capability is there. It just took a while for them to get in gear today.
And that's been the case. I mean, last year it was the case.
Sure.
But they do have the ability to play very patiently because as an attacking style team, they know their opportunities will come and they know they have the ability to score very quickly. I mean, they haven't scored. They've only scored 10 points here in the second half. And it feels like they haven't done much offensively. But you look at the numbers and you look at the way things bear out. And you say, wow, they're in midseason form.
And they're up over 500 yards of offense. Just a hair under their average in terms of scoring offense from last year. But it was an adventure getting there. There's Tyler again, a career high in carries for him, 28th of the afternoon. But this was the crucial moment of the game. Last drive, this pass interference call on a 3rd and 12.
Tough situation. Van Leeuwen unable to make that play, but gets the flag and then the beautiful call on the shovel pass. And then the touchdown. And that might have been all they needed, especially with UConn's inability to consistently move the ball and score.
Jim Moore calling his second timeout.
Think about those turnovers and how costly they all were. They were moving the ball. Turner has the pick. They have the fumble from Carter. And then the pick there from Larson. Costly turnovers, but a really valiant effort from a young team.
Now it's Tyler. Gonna put the cherry on top here. Bronte Jones with the tackle, first down for Utah State. The clock will stop to move the chains.
And this is a situation in a game, just like any situation in any game, that's a teachable situation for this Utah State team and Blake Anderson. Run the clock, finish the game, ball security. Not always easy to slow things down for a team that knows how to play very quickly in Utah State. This still is a relatively tight game, and Moore is still coaching his guys.
Final timeout for UConn. So next week, Utah State will visit number one Alabama. It's only the second game against the number one ranked team in the AP poll in program history, the first one since 1984. They played BYU in 84, lost them, lost to Nebraska in 1971. Do you think they give Bama a game next week?
You never
know.
It's
a warm-up game in some respects.
In the world of college football, you never know. They certainly have the experience at the quarterback position to not be intimidated in that environment. But physically, you look at the way UConn was able to run the ball today, and you'd have to say Alabama's going to try to do a lot more of the same with a lot different-looking guys.
Different level of athleticism. Sure. That's to take nothing away from the effort that UConn put forth here today. They threw everything they had at Utah State. They'll begin conference play on September 24th.
Tough game last year with UNLV.
Again, every game ought to be tough because of slow starts. But hey, they were fun to watch.
And I think Coach Anderson wants to see his bell cow running back, Calvin Tyler Jr., finish this game strong, without turnovers, show his conditioning, show what level he's changed since last year.
We thought there might have been some sort of pitch count on Tyler today. But clearly he has been able to manage that workload. Career high in rushing attempts today, now over 30.
Briggs was impactful. Makakona, we saw with the fumble, they got him going a little bit, but it's been Tyler and Briggs.
Another carry on first down. And look at the balance. 281 passing yards, 255 rushing yards for Utah State. It's kind of what they want here to get just a little bit more tilted towards that running game. And here's UConn again as an independent.
And you
face number 8 Michigan.
Yeah. Jim Mora telling his team to fight. Still pushing them out there. Central Connecticut State.
The Blue Devils.
I see that. That looks like a Blue Devil there. Fresno State.
Yeah, they're about to go 0-6 all time against Mountain West opposition, UConn.
Jake Hayner.
Back at Fresno for another year. What a fun team to watch the Mountain West this year. As Tyler gets another carry. And now you're at that point where UConn has nothing left in the tank. Another first down for Tyler.
Out of timeouts. Jim Mora still coaching that D, still pushing his guys, trying to set a foundation for the way the program is going in the future. And I think if you're a UConn person and you've seen all the tumult of the last few years, you got to feel pretty good about the way Coach Mora's team came out and fought, especially after losing Roberson so early.
Yeah. Back in the first quarter, you lose your starting quarterback and still manage to put up a really, really valiant fight. And they were pushing the Aggies around for large stretches of this game. They are a minute 20 away from defeat. And Utah State winding this thing down. Not pretty. They will not get those style points today, but they will get the W.
Well, you would expect Blake Anderson's team, as a guy who's a really organized head coach, knows what he wants to do offensively. The team understands their personality. You see him there talking to Ephraim Banda, his defensive coordinator. They get down in a game and they don't panic. And they're able to work their system and find success. And that's what we saw here today. It's a heck of a flat top, too. He looks a lot like Joel Klatt. Look at that. That's a Klatt look.
We'll see Joel and Alabama in a couple weeks on Fox when the Tide face the Texas Longhorns. But for now, Utah State, they want back. That's up next. Jim Mora coached the heck out of his Huskies today. And Logan Bonner, in his 26th consecutive start for Utah State, picks up the victory, winds up throwing for 281 yards and three touchdowns today.
You know, I think Utah State is still a real force in the Mountain West, no doubt about that. But I felt good about the way UConn fought today, given what they've been through over the years.
Perhaps a turning point for the Huskies program. Still has a long way to go as an independent. But Utah State is off to a 1-0 start after getting through week zero relatively unscathed. 31-20 the final from Logan, Utah. For Petros Papadakis, our producer Brad Weimer, director Brian Biederman, and our entire crew, this is Alex Faust bidding you a good afternoon, and thanks for watching Week Zero College Football on FS1.